upon him. But the wrath of God is against the heaven, against all ungodliness and all unrighteousness of men, who suppress the truth of God and unrighteousness. But the Lord Jesus Christ will be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels and flaming fire, bringing vengeance upon all of his adversaries, on those who do not believe in God, and on those who do not obey the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Seek the Lord and live today.
Seek God and believe the gospel. And not be a fucking ass.
Why are you May the Lord bless you for turning away from you all your iniquities, okay? Seek the Lord and live today. See, folks, outside of Christ, we're angry people. Outside of Christ, we don't know the love of God. Outside of Christ, we walk in rebellion and anarchy towards God. The Bible says that we love darkness.
The Bible says he humbled himself and became a man. He did not know sin, but yet he became sin.
Creature, all things have passed away.
wickedness. Surrender your life to Jesus Christ today and live. Look to him to be saved, all you ends of the earth. For he is the Lord your God, and there is no other. Oh, the Bible says, Jesus said that, as in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. Oh, friends, in Noah's day, they were eating and drinking and giving themselves up to marriage, building and planting, planning, oh, friends, and then sudden destruction came upon them. The flood of God's wrath came upon Noah's people at the time, and only Noah, righteous Noah, who found grace in the eyes of God and his family, were the only ones that were saved, because they entered into love, him and the animals, and everyone else died. Oh, friends, God flooded the earth for 40 days and 40 nights, and all of the earth was washed away, and only Noah and his family lived, and all the animals in the ark. That is a type and a symbol, folks. Jesus Christ is that ark. If you enter into him, when the flood of God's wrath comes again, you will be saved. But God has made a promise unto all of humanity. God has made a promise to you. God has made a promise to me. And that promise is the rainbow. And that is not a promise of perversion. Oh, friend, that does not signify sodomy. But it signifies that God will destroy the earth in a flaming fire. Oh, friends, the devil uses what God intends for good. The devil twists it and makes it for evil. Oh, you may look at the rainbow and use it for a different purpose, but God created the rainbow to promise that he will never destroy the earth with water, but with fire. The Bible says that the Lord Jesus Christ is going to be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels and flaming fire, bringing vengeance upon all of his adversaries, on those who do not believe in God, and on those who have not obeyed the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Oh, folks, God will destroy the earth in flaming fire. The Bible says that the elements will burn in fervent heat, that the mountains will melt like wax. Oh, folks, this is going to be a great and terrible day. There's going to be people that flee to the mountains, the Bible says. Or they're going to run to the mountains and ask for the mountains and the clefts of the rock to fall upon them, because the wrath of the Lamb is coming. Oh, friend, you're going to wish you were never born than to face the wrath of God. Don't die your sins. Be right with God. Repent and believe in the gospel. Turn to the Lord Jesus Christ.
The Bible says that although you know who God is, you don't want to retain him in your honors, that you suppress the truth of God in unrighteousness. Oh, folks, if you turn your ear away from the law.
And the Bible says if you turn your ear away from the law, even your prayer shall be an abomination unto the Lord. Oh, seek the Lord. Turn to Jesus and live. Folks, wisdom cries aloud in the streets. She lifts up her voice. It says in Proverbs 1, verse 20. We'll read that to you today. We'll read the Word of God with you. We share the Word of God with you, folks. Folks, this could be your last day on earth. What if you die? What if you breathe your last breath and have your last heartbeat? Oh, your favorite team will not save you from the wrath of God. Your money will not save you from the wrath of God. The Bible says riches profit nothing on the day of wrath, but righteousness delivers from death. You need the righteousness of Christ, folks. Don't put your faith, don't put your trust in uncertain riches, because surely riches grow wings like eagles, and they fly away. Wisdom cries without, she utters her voice in the streets. She cries the chief place of concourse, in the openings of the gates, in the city she utters her words. How long, you simple ones, will you love simplicity, and the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge? Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you, because I have called, and you refused. I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded. Oh, folks, God is stretching out his hand to the proclamation of his holy gospel towards you today, and you're not regarding his word. He has called, but you refuse to answer. And then he says in verse 25, but you have said and not all of his counsel, and with none of his reproof. He will also laugh at your calamity when your terror comes like a whirlwind, the Bible says, where fear comes as desolation and destruction and comes as a whirlwind. All friends, distress and anger shall come upon you. Then shall you call upon him, but he will not answer. You shall seek him early, but you shall not find him. For they that hated knowledge, oh friends, do not hate the knowledge of the Lord today. The Bible says, fearing the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. Seek the Lord. May the Lord bless you from turning you away from all your iniquities in Jesus' name. Oh, humble yourselves. Repent and turn to Jesus Christ.
Let's go and stop all of this until you're going to come out of the captive call. Trust in Jesus and Jesus alone. Jesus Christ is crucified once for sins and just for the unjust. Don't put your faith in a priest or a pope or a nail or a saint, but in Jesus and Jesus alone.
Jesus said in John 14:6, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man comes to God the Father except it be through him. Oh, folks, turn and live, declares the Lord. Look to Jesus and be saved today. Call upon his precious holy name. Seek the Lord and live. Repent and believe in the gospel. Jesus came to seek and save that which is lost. Jesus came to save sinners. Oh, folks, and you are a sinner. Outside of Christ, you are dead in your sins. But the good news of the gospel is that Jesus Christ came to save those kind of people. Jesus Christ came to save liars, thieves, idolaters, murderers, drunkards, the sexually immoral. Oh, friends, he came to save sinners like you and I. And it's by God's grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone, can you receive this gift, can you receive eternal life. Oh, friends, turn to Jesus today and live. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him come to our Lord, for he will have mercy, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. He that has the Son has life, but he that does not have the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides upon him. Who has warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Who has warned you to flee from the wrath to come? How can you escape if you neglect so great a salvation? Turn to Jesus and live. Get right with God before it is too late before you die in your sins. It is appointed for man once to die, and after this, the judgment. Oh, you're going to stand before God one day and give an account for everything you've done in your body, whether that be good or evil. Every action, every word, every thought will be made manifest in the light of God. Oh, folks, there's nothing that you can hide from God. The Bible says the eyes of the Lord are in all places, keeping watch on the good and the evil. And on that day of judgment, all the secrets in your heart will be judged by Jesus Christ. Get right with the Lord. Get right with Jesus today. Repent and believe the gospel. Time is running out. Your days are numbered. Turn and live, declares the Lord. Look to me and be saved, all you into the earth, for he is the Lord your God and there is no other. Look to Jesus and live. Repent and believe the gospel. Come up from among them and be separate, declares the Lord. Do not touch it as unclean, you will be a father unto them. And you shall be his sons and daughters. Turn to Jesus and live today. Give life with God. We must be born again in order to seek God's kingdom. He that has the Son has life, but he that does not have the Son shall not see life. But the wrath of God abides upon him. Folks, flee from the wrath that is to come. The Lord Jesus Christ will be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels and flaming fire, bringing vengeance upon all of his adversaries, on those who do not believe in God, and on those who have not obeyed the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. All the wrath of God will be upon all the children of disobedience. It's a matter of obedience. It's either you obey God and live, or die in your sins. Oh, friends, do not die in your sins, but live. God does not take pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that sinner should come to repentance. If you go to hell, my friend, it is all your fault because your heart and your heart turns God, because you rejected the Lord Jesus Christ. You rejected the Lord's word. Be right with the one true God today. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Seek the Lord and live. Call upon him while he is near. He that has the Son has life, but he that does not have the Son shall not see life. But the wrath of God abides upon him.
Light a cigarette?
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but they shall have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into this world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved.
high school. I know all this. I'm not giving a shit. This is that's actually like pretty impressive that you guys like stand out here. Like, I think we're mad props in that.
If you really impressed with Jesus,
turn to Jesus.
Yeah, no, I get that. Yeah. But like, do people like keep doing like, give you like a lot of like shit? Do people like yell at you?
Alright,
I'll meet
you. There's no other God. There's no other King.
Do people give you a lot of shit like all the time?
Depends on the day, sometimes more, sometimes less.
Especially in Seattle, people have to come up and be like, oh, like, fuck you, like,
final call for you.
That's
this
so
could
nice.
Be your final yeah. call. This could be I your mean, last they opportunity them, you to fight you. With God.
Yeah.
This day could be your like, last, you know, for you, like, know, right? You don't know.
You yell that a lot?
Sometimes I just can't pass by, just
don't know.
Yeah, right? You know, yeah, people are just
alright, I'll see you. Or next week, or next year.
Yeah,
now is the day of salvation.
People have to.
Turn to Jesus Christ and live.
Right?
Your days are numbered.
It's okay, we're not.
Yeah,
we reconcile to God. Surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ today and live. You must be born again.
That's fair. It's completely fair.
Glory to God.
It's like, you're doing what you believe in. And like, I respect that. Nah, dude, I went to Catholic school.
You're in great danger, so you got to come out of the Catholic church.
Actually, like, out of curiosity, so you...
We're Christians.
You're Christian.
You got to read the
like
Bible.
Evangelist? Yeah. I've read the Bible. I know what it is.
You got to read the Word of God to know what is true, man.
I know.
You should care. You say you don't care, but...
I don't care.
You should.
No, I've been there.
Doesn't it concern you that you're on your way to hell?
Yeah. I mean, not really. Like...
You have no fear of God in your eyes.
Not at all.
See.
I mean, no. I mean, I got my own God, like that.
Of course you do. But you got to get right with the God of the Bible.
Otherwise
you'll die in your sins.
Yeah.
Even God can't save you. Only Jesus can save you.
Yeah. I mean, and like I totally understand how like that's like your vibe.
No, it's not my thoughts. It's the truth.
Yeah, exactly. And like, I completely like. I mean, you're out here doing what you think's right, and I'm not saying it's wrong, at all. I mean, everyone's got their own thoughts. I'm just out here just curious for how many people just got, like, especially in Seattle, people got to be coming out of here, like...
Do you know why you need to be saved?
Why do I need to be saved?
Yeah.
Dude, I've heard this shit, like, for the last 4 years in high school. I know. It's like, oh, yeah, you got to repent, you got to go, like, you got to go to fucking confession.
No.
And like, oh, yeah, you got to, like, you got to...
Yeah, see, one second,
this is a kid. I don't want this.
You don't have to go to confess your sins to a priest or trust in the Pope or pray to saints or Marys or do religious works or attend the Mass or drink the Eucharist. That's all an abomination to God, okay? See, that's a Roman Catholic tradition. That's not going to save anybody. And no Roman Catholic is a Christian. There's a huge difference, okay? See, the Bible says that Jesus is the eternal Son of God.
I've read the Bible.
Then why are you still unconverted if you read the whole Bible?
Why am I unconverted?
Yeah.
First off, super love having sex. It's awesome. It's great. Second off,
God created sex, man. But the Bible says that
I know
that
the
marriage
says,
be
dude.
Let the marriage bed okay. be without
dude.
Defilement.
I know. I know.
Married.
I know. I know.
Come
you, you don't. You don't have to like tell me the Bible.
Yes, I do.
I know.
Well, you obviously don't because you're not saved. Because if you did know, you wouldn't be walking in sin.
I do know. I do know. Trust me. I do know. I've read it, and like, I mean, it's just my vibe, like. It's like, the way I understand it, it's like, basically, don't be a dick, essentially, right? Don't be a dick. And I'm not saying y'all are being a dick at all. Like, you're out here doing what you think is right, which I respect a lot. Like, you're out here with big-ass motherfucking signs,
wow.
And like...
You don't have to curse, man. There's no reason to curse. The Bible says, if you delight in cursing, let cursing come upon you, since you don't delight in blessing.
Yeah.
So when you're born again, you won't be cursing anymore. That's the miracle, man.
Have you eaten shellfish? You only like the New Testament, right?
We preach the full counsel of God, sir.
So, you like the New Testament?
We love the whole Bible.
You like, so it's you fuck with the, oh, excuse me, sorry. I'll try to stop. Sorry, it's like, yeah, it's more of a habit. So like, you like
when
the-
When you come to Jesus-
No, I got one. I got one in my pocket, don't
please
worry.
Please read it.
No, I mean-
When you come to Jesus, here's the miracle. What's your name?
I'm BJ.
BJ.
Like Bojan.
Michael,
pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Michael. Here's the thing, man. When you come to Jesus,
Vladimir, that's an awesome name. That's a good ass name. Sorry, it's
when you
sorry.
When you come to Jesus, he'll give you a new heart, man. He'll give you a new state of mind. You won't curse out of your mouth anymore, man. All this here's the miracle of salvation. All the sins you love doing now, and all the sins that you indulge in right now.
I feel you.
All the things you do right now, you're going to hate that stuff, man. That's the miracle. Only God can open your eyes. You tell me your heart. I understand where you're coming from. You're dead in your sins.
What if he died today?
If I died today, I'd be dead. Like, really?
You don't care.
I really don't care.
Yeah,
you're
dead in your sins. That's what the Bible says. You're dead in your sins. Like,
no, I'll just be dead as a
dead corpse before me right now. I kick at it, screaming, I yell, hey, come to Jesus, come to Jesus. Is it going to come to Jesus? No, it's dead. That's how you are right now.
Yeah.
Well, you
definitely
need a miracle, man. You need God to raise you from the dead. You need God to breathe the breath of life into you. You need Jesus. God commands you to repent, to come out of your sin, man. Come out of your
fornication,
like
a Catholic. You sound like a Catholic.
No, I'm not
you
a Catholic.
You sound like a Catholic.
I'm a Christian.
Okay, like,
born again Christian.
Just purely out of just curiosity.
I'm not going to tell you to confess your sins to a priest.
No.
I'm not going to tell you to go pray to the marriage.
I'm just like, out of curiosity. Were you all like born and raised into like this religion?
No.
No?
No.
Really?
I've been a Christian for 2 years.
2 years? That's awesome.
It's a miracle.
How'd you find it? Yeah, I mean,
it's a
like,
miracle. And that you gotta see God, man. You gotta ask God to give you faith.
All right, don't.
You gotta ask God to save you from your sins.
Yeah.
Otherwise,
I mean,
you're in great danger.
That's fine. That's cool. But like, would you mind like getting like hella evangelist here, I mean, for like 2 seconds? Like, just ask you.
You gotta know. What do you want to say?
I'm just curious as like how you like came to this.
Jesus saved us, man.
No, I know.
It's a miracle. Listen, man, if it weren't by the grace of God, I'd be doing what most people are doing today. Not thinking about God. I would be smoking and drinking and sleeping with girls. But Jesus saved me. That's
amazing. And like,
and you need him to save you.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's cool. But like, I'm just curious. Like, so like, you said 2 years ago, like, what brought you to this conclusion? Or like
the gospel.
Like, okay, then how do you find the gospel?
The gospel found me. I wasn't seeking for God at all. Listen to me, man.
No, I know.
I didn't care about God at all. I was in the same position as you are.
No,
I didn't care.
I know.
But
I feel it.
God came to me.
No, I okay. Minus like all this. I'm trying not to cuss because I don't want to like cuss in front of y'all. But like, I'm just like curious as to like actually like where like how do you like where how like in the streets how do you find the gospel? Or like, where did he go?
Somebody was preaching the gospel. You see us preaching? Yeah, there was someone preaching.
It was actually that guy over there.
No shit, really? Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. I guess, yeah. So like,
BJ, can we pray for you?
Yeah.
Can we pray for you?
Nah, okay? I don't care, dude.
Just as long as your smoke doesn't get in my face, because I really don't.
Oh, yeah, no. If you don't, yeah, if you don't want, yeah, no.
Let's pray for
BJ. Yeah, go for it.
Father God, we come before you, Lord God. We pray for BJ, Lord God. We pray, Lord, that you'd have mercy upon him, Lord God. We pray, Lord, that you'd give him eyes to see, Lord God, that you would break his heart, Lord God, that you would show him his sin, Lord God, and that you would recognize, Lord God, that he's just so far gone from you, Lord God, that you would deliver him, Father God, from his addiction and his slavery to sin, Lord God.
Okay, I'm gonna stop.
God, I pray that you would just have mercy upon him, Lord God. You would open his eyes to see the beautiful light of the glorious gospel of Jesus, and that you would open his ears, Father God, to hear your word. Please, Lord God, we know that if you're not the one that moves, Father God, into his heart and does the miracle, Father God, he will never come to you. He will never believe. He will be damned to hell for all of eternity, Lord God. So, Father God, I pray that you would have mercy upon him, Lord God, and you would open his eyes, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Yeah, no, that's fair. That's fair. Trust me.
He had mercy upon you.
No, I used to be a Christian. I used to be a Christian.
Well, you never were a Christian.
No, I was. I used to be. I mean, like, now you're telling me, like, what I used to not be.
If you really were a Christian, I used to believe in all this. If you really were a Christian, you wouldn't be in the state you're in right now.
Trust me, I used to. I mean, now you're telling me like what I was and wasn't. Like,
well, I know what you are, okay? I know what you are because the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart that the mouth speaks. So what comes out of your mouth, I can know what's coming
from
your heart.
It's actually pretty impressive that you like memorize the Bible very well. So, and I'm not discrediting like all that shit.
I understand, but here's the thing, man. You're not a Christian. You're in great danger.
No, I'm not a Christian.
And God commands you to repent and turn from your sins.
No, I mean, that's
without Christ, you'll go
totally
to hell,
fair.
Man.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I know.
It's interesting that you would waste time and talk to us and not go to the game.
No, exactly. But the thing is, like, I like to meet, like, a lot of people. And I, like, I'm not out here, like, being like, oh, fuck y'all. Sorry, I guess again. You know, because you get a lot of people. You got Ash right here. Oh, no, it's not Ash. I think it might be a little, right here. It might be, like, a little. And it's, and, like, the reason I came up to y'all is not, like, because I'm trying to repent. Because I used to be Christian. And, like, for me, it's not really, it's not what I like, I'm not gonna lie.
Of course.
And it's not because it's like, oh, I wanted to like be all simple and shit like that.
You love darkness more than light. You love evil more than good.
Yeah, I mean, I like the sun. It's just, yeah, whatever. I mean, don't throw me shade right now. I'm just trying to talk to you. The reason I came up to y'all is because, like, I'm actually just, like, really curious. And it's more of, like, a curiosity of, like how y'all, like, came to this. You know what I mean?
By God's grace, man.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, yeah, God's grace, I know. Everyone fucking says that. Sorry, I cussed him. Whatever. Whatever. But, like, I'm just curious. This is, like, you already told me. How did you grow up in a Christian family?
I did.
Yeah. So, did your parents do this?
No.
That's bad. So, like, are they like stoked on you doing this kind of thing?
Nope.
No, not at all.
I've been doing what you were doing, drinking, smoking.
Yeah, that's what I was exactly. Doing. Okay. So, like.
And then one day, a miracle happened.
That's fair.
God saved.
That's fair. Well, first off, smoking tobacco is not the sin. No, it's not. It's like literally.
It's
not.
Poison.
It's poison. Yeah, your body is simple. I know that. But it's also not a sin.
No, and not even that. Your body's not the temple of the Holy Ghost because you're not saved yet. You don't have His Holy Ghost.
Okay. So, but now you're throwing shade. I don't care about this whole Bible shit that you're like. I'm just out here like trying
to. Come
like,
to Christ. Dude, come to Christ. We gotta go. You gotta go. You don't want to talk about God?
Hope next time you come to us and you'll be saved. You'll repent.
You'll be saved. Maybe God's grace.
Pray.
I guess I'm a fucking man, actually.
Lord have mercy on me.
No, it's fine. No, I'm just like really curious. So
read the Bible, man. Seek the Lord.
I've read the Bible. I know what the Bible says.
Read it again.
I've read it.
Read that gospel track you gave me, man.
I know the gospel.
Seek the Lord with all your heart.
Have you ever thought that like you know like people with schizophrenia? Right? When you read the Bible, and you kind of think about it, and you're hearing voices, like...
That's demons, that's what they hear.
That's demons. Like, what do you think of Ouija boards?
Satanic.
Demonic.
Not just like a...
Everything is spiritual.
So when you think, like, some people are hearing voices, like, the people are hearing the gospel, like...
Excuse me.
So, it's like kind of seminal, right?
We have
get a sandwich.
We hear his word.
Is that good?
Chicken.
Is that pork?
No, it's good. Chicken.
Oh, chicken. Yeah.
Looks good.
Yeah. You can go to Al's down there.
And like, I'm not trying to come out here like at all, like to be one of the, because like, I'm not trying to be one of those people that run out to be like, oh fuck y'all, because like, I just like hearing like everyone's kind of point of view sort of thing, and that's the only reason I came up to y'all. It's like I like to hear like everyone's point of view.
You must be born again.
No, yeah, no, totally, yeah. I get
come
it.
To Christ.
Yeah, I get it.
Get right with God.
I get it. I get that point. But like,
talk to the Lord Jesus. Come to the love of Jesus.
I know.
Get right with God.
I know. I get it. I just like am really interested in like everyone's like kind of like thought process.
Get angle.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And like that's.
We're thinking about the word. I'm thinking Jesus. About the
get
word
right with
of
God.
God.
Get right with God.
Places keeping watch of the good and the evil. And on that day of judgment, all the secrets in your heart will be judged by Jesus Christ. Get right with the Lord. Get right with Jesus today. Repent and believe the gospel. Time is running out. Your days are numbered. Turn and live, declares the Lord. Look to me and be saved. All you into the earth, for He is the Lord your God and there is no other. Look to Jesus and live. Repent and believe the gospel. Come up from among them and be set with the Son of the Lord. Do not touch it as unclean, you will be a father unto them. And you shall bear sons and daughters. Turn to Jesus and live today. Give life with God. You must be born again in order to seek God's kingdom. He that has the Son has life. But he that does not have the Son shall not see life. But the wrath of God abides upon him. Folks, flee from the wrath that is to come. The Lord Jesus Christ will move here from heaven with his mighty angels and flaming fire, bringing vengeance upon all of his adversaries, on those who do not believe in God, and on those who have obeyed the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. All the wrath of God will be upon all the children of disobedience. Oh, friends, God commands you to repent and believe today. It's not an option for you. It's a matter of obedience. It's either you obey God and live, or die in your sins. Oh, friends, do not die in your sins, but live. God
but that sinner should come to repentance. If you go to hell, no friend, it is all your fault because your heart and your heart turns God. Because you rejected the Lord Jesus Christ. You rejected the Lord's word. We invite you to worship God today. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. Seek the Lord and live.
I respect that. Nah, dude, I went to Catholic school.
You're in great danger, so you got to come out of the Catholic church.
Actually, like, out of curiosity, so you...
We're Christians.
You're Christian.
You got to read the
like
Bible.
Evangelist? Yeah. I've read the Bible. I know what it is.
You got to read the Word of God to know what is true, man.
I know.
You should care. You say you don't care, but I don't care.
I really should. No, I've been there.
Doesn't it concern you that you're on your way to hell?
Yeah. I mean, not really. Like,
you have no fear of God in your eyes.
Not at all.
See.
I got my own God like that.
Of course you do. But you got to get right with the God of the Bible.
Otherwise
you'll die in your sins.
Yeah.
God can't save you. Only Jesus can save you.
Yeah. I mean, and like I totally understand how like that's like your vibe.
No, it's not my thought. It's the truth.
Yeah. Exactly. And like I completely I mean, you're out here doing what you think's right, and I'm not saying it's wrong at all. I mean, everyone's got their own thoughts. I'm just out here just curious for how many people just got, like, especially in Seattle, people got to be coming out of here, like...
Do you know why you need to be saved?
Why do I need to be saved?
Yeah.
Dude, I've heard this shit, like, for the last 4 years in high school. I know. It's like, oh, yeah, you got to repent, you got to go to fucking confession.
No.
And like, oh, yeah, you got to...
Yeah, see,
One second, there's a kid. I don't want to start.
You don't have to go to confess your sins to a priest or trust in the Pope or pray to saints or Marys or do religious works or attend the Mass or drink the Eucharist. That's all an abomination to God, okay? So that's a Roman Catholic tradition. That's not going to save anybody. And no Roman Catholic is a Christian. There's a huge difference, okay? See, the Bible says that Jesus is the eternal Son of God.
I know what the Bible says. I've read the Bible.
Then why are you still unconverted if you read the whole Bible?
Why am I unconverted?
Yeah.
First off, super love having sex. It's awesome. It's great. Second off,
God created sex, man. But the Bible says that
let the marriage bed be
without defilement.
I know. You don't have to like tell me the Bible.
Yes, I do.
I know.
Well, you obviously don't because you're not saved. Because if you did know, you wouldn't be walking in sin.
I do know. Trust me, I do know. I've read it, and like, I mean, it's just my vibe, like. It's like the way I understand it. It's like basically, don't be a dick. Essentially, right? Don't be a dick. And I'm not saying y'all are being a dick at all. Like, you're out here doing what you think is right, which I respect a lot. Like, you're out here with big ass motherfucking signs,
you don't have to curse, man. There's no reason to curse. The Bible says if you delight in cursing, let cursing come upon you, since you don't delight in blessing.
Yeah.
So when you're born again, you won't be cursing anymore. That's the miracle, man.
Have you eaten shellfish? You only like the New Testament, right?
No, we preach the full counsel of God, sir.
So you like the New Testament?
We love the whole Bible.
You like, so it's you fuck with the... Oh, excuse me, sorry. I'll try to stop. Sorry, it's more of a habit. So like, you like the...
When you come to Jesus...
No, I got one. I got one in my pocket. Don't
worry. Please read it.
No, I mean...
When you come to Jesus, here's the miracle. What's your name?
I'm BJ.
BJ.
Like Bojan.
Michael.
Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Michael. Here's the thing, man. When you come to Jesus...
Vladimir? That's an awesome name. That's a good-ass name. Sorry, it's kind of scary.
When you come to Jesus, he'll give you a new heart, man. He'll give you a new state of mind. You won't curse out of your mouth anymore, man. Here's the miracle of salvation. All the sins you love doing now, and all the sins that you indulge in right now...
I feel you.
All the things you do right now, you're going to hate that stuff, man. That's the miracle. Only God can open your eyes. You tell me your heart. I understand where you're coming from. You're dead in your sins.
What if you died today?
If I died today, I'd be dead. Like, really?
You don't care.
I really don't care.
Yeah,
you're
dead in your sins. That's what the Bible says. You're dead in your sins.
I'll just be dead as a motherfucker.
A dead corpse before me right now. I kick at it, scream at it, yell, hey, come to Jesus, come to Jesus. Is it going to come to Jesus? No, it's dead. That's how you are right now.
Yeah.
Well, you
definitely
need a miracle, man. You need God to raise you from the dead. You need God to breathe the breath of life into you. You need Jesus. God commands you to repent, to come out of your sin, man. Come out of your fornication.
You sound like a Catholic.
No, I'm not a Catholic. I'm a Christian.
Okay, like
born again Christian.
Just purely out of just curiosity.
I'm not going to tell you to confess your sins to a priest.
No.
I'm not going to tell you to pray to
marriage. I'm just out of curiosity. Were you like, were y'all like born and raised into like this religion?
No.
No?
No.
Really?
I've been a Christian for 2 years.
2 years? That's awesome.
It's a miracle.
How'd you find it? Yeah, I mean,
it's a miracle. And that you gotta see God, man. You gotta ask God to give you faith.
All right, don't.
You gotta ask God to save you from your sins.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're in great danger.
Yeah, that's fine. That's cool. But like, would you mind like getting like hella evangelistic on me for like 2 seconds? Like, just ask you.
You gotta know. What do you have? What do you want to say?
I'm just curious as like how you like came to this.
Jesus saved us, man.
No, I know.
It's a miracle. Listen, man. If it weren't by the grace of God, I'd be doing what most people are doing today. Not thinking about God. I would be smoking and drinking and sleeping with girls. But Jesus saved me. That's
amazing. And like,
and you need Him to save you.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's cool. But like, I'm just curious. Like, so like, you said 2 years ago. Like, what brought you to this conclusion? Or like
the gospel.
Like, okay, then how do you find the gospel?
The gospel found me. I wasn't seeking for God at all. Listen to me, man.
No, I know.
I didn't care about God at all. I was in the same position as you are.
No,
I didn't care.
I know.
But
I feel it.
God came to me.
No, okay. Minus like all this. I'm trying not to cuss because I don't want to like cuss in front of y'all. But like, I'm just like curious as to like actually like where like how do you like where how like in the streets how do you find the gospel? Or where did you go?
Somebody was preaching the gospel. See us preaching? Yeah, there was someone preaching.
It was actually that guy over there.
No shit, really? Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. I guess, yeah. So, like,
BJ, can we pray for you?
Yeah.
Can you pray for you?
No, okay? I don't care. Dude.
Just as long as your smoke doesn't get in my face, because I really don't.
Oh, yeah. No, if you don't, yeah. If you don't want, yeah, no.
Okay, let's pray for
BJ. Yeah, go for it.
Father God, we come before you, Lord God. We pray for BJ, Lord God. We pray, Lord, that you'd have mercy upon him, Lord God. We pray, Lord, that you'd give him eyes to see, Lord God, that you would break his heart, Lord God, that you would show him his sin, Lord God, that you would recognize, Lord God, that he's just so far gone from you, Lord God, that you would deliver him, Father God, from his addiction and his slavery to sin, Lord God.
Okay, I'm gonna stop.
God, I pray that you would just have mercy upon him, Lord God. You would open his eyes to see the beautiful light of the glorious gospel of Jesus, and that you would open his ears, Father God, to hear your word. Please, Lord God, we know that if you're not the one that moves, Father God, into his heart and does the miracle, Father God, he will never come to you. He will never believe. He will be damned to hell for all of eternity, Lord God. So, Father God, I pray that you would have mercy upon him, Lord God, and you would open his eyes, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.